Crisp, animated SVGs are popping up in more and more places these days, but have you ever tried making one? It's an awful experience. Trying to code out complex visual elements is hard enough, but getting them to flow and fit together is even worse. So let's talk about how to solve that. Bodymovin is an open source library that allows you to export from After Effects into SVG or Canvas. Yeah, that's right, After Effects. First released in 2015, it's a worn-in and very active project, and it's used in more places than you would expect. So what kind of things can we do with this? Surprisingly, or maybe not, the hardest part of using Bodymovin is actually getting the plugin into After Effects. I went for the install method using the Adobe Store, but it took a while for Creative Cloud to recognize the new file and enable it. There's a more manual install method, but I'm still an AE newbie and I opted for the lazy way. Once you've got the Bodymovin extension installed, simply pop it open in After Effects and you're home free. As you can see here, I've got the TopTech video intro pulled up, but I've made a few slight changes to make it more loopable, which is something you'll probably want to do too. On video, a one-way animation is fine, but in most other cases, you want the ability to reset the animation and play it again. Now, if you think After Effects is a bit intimidating, I promise it's not. Many of us have played around with Flash back in the day, and the process in AE will be familiar. Even without that experience, a quick couple of YouTube tutorials will get you through. When you're happy with your composition, go into the Bodymovin panel and select it. You can go into the more advanced settings, but generally speaking, you don't need to. Next, we'll select a destination, render it out, and we're done. The JSON file here is what holds all the information about the composition. We'll throw this into a simple HTML page so we can take a look at our work. We'll include the Bodymovin JavaScript library and create our animation. There's a ton of parameters allowing you to navigate to specific frames, set playback speed, and even reverse the animation. There's also an event listener for every realistic need. We'll keep it simple though. We'll turn on autoplay, turn on loop, and go. Let's see how we did. All in all, this thing is friggin' awesome. I had all sorts of doubts prior. Buggy, slow, resource intensive, quality degradation. In reality though, it's a seamless experience that provides stunning results. I should also mention that Airbnb has developed a library that allows you to render Bodymovin JSON on Android and iOS natively. Yeah, I'm gonna bookmark this repo.